Hello friends, this is Tanu from Aussie's Clayton and good afternoon to all of you. And today I'm very happy because I've got with me Ayushi, who has joined recently and she's teaching here and she's one of the PTE tutors here. So Ayushi, introduce yourself.
Hi friends, my name is Ayushi and I teach with Tanu in Aussie's Clayton and I'm very happy today to see you all.
So, we are here because we will be talking about a very important topic of PTE, Pearson Test of English, as you all know. And we will be talking about a task from listening section, listening module today, which is called Write From Dictation. And friends, it is one of the most important tasks of listening module and it has got the highest weightage of all the tasks. Among all the tasks, it is one of the tasks which has got the highest weightage. It is more than 45 marks, isn't it, Ayushi?
It is, and it is an integrated task which has got marks in listening as well as in writing.
Yeah. So, friends, as she already mentioned, it is, you know, the marks are going towards your writing as well as a listening. So, which both are, you know, very important modules, and this only very task has got more than 45 marks. So there is no room to make a single mistake in this task. The better you do this task, the better marks you get in your exam. So Ayushi, let's start. How many number of questions do students usually should expect in this particular module?
It can vary. Some students say they got only 2 right from dictation. Some says they got 3. As an average, they get 3 to 4 of these questions. And this is the listening very last question. So you have to maintain the time and you have to see that you have got enough time to do this question. So it is really very important question. If by chance you got more number of question and you miss to do this task, then what happens is you will not, it's very light chances that you can pass in your listening as well as writing. Now she will tell you what is this task all about.
Yeah. So friends, as she already mentioned, the number of question you should be expecting is between 3 to 4. The moment a question starts, you get 7 seconds before the actual audio begins, before you actually need to start typing. The audio would be just about 3 to 4 seconds long. It would not be a very, very long question, very, very, very long sentence. I would say the length of the sentence generally varies between somewhere around 6 to go up till sometimes 14 words. So when the words are more than 10, it's a bit of a struggle to, you know, write the complete sentence. But as I already mentioned, it is a very important task. So putting each and every word in the right order is very, very important. So you cannot rephrase the sentence. So it is not, you know, if you have a very long sentence, you can rephrase and put some words here and there. You can't do that because of course you lose marks. And is there any negative mark, Ayushi?
There is no negative marking on this. Per word you write, you will get the mark of each word. So what happens is, when you listen to an audio, your task is to write the whole complete sentence in the correct order. So computer matches word by word and give you each word is counted and given, you'll be given marks on the basis of that. So sometimes the sentence is 6 word long, then it's easy to write. You can just listen the sentence and straight away start typing on the computer. But many times what happens is a sentence is really lengthy and fast. So what is the way do you think the student should do to get the maximum number of marks and to get the whole sentence correct?
First of all, friends, it's very, very important to do the bulk practice of this task. Okay, why I'm saying it, because practicing 5 or 6 or 10 sentences a day would not be enough in order for you to make, you know, in order to get perfect score in this task. It is very, very important to do bulk practice. By bulk practice, I mean you need to sit for at least 20 to 25 minutes, practice minimum 30 to 35 sentences, so that you need to get used to about the accent. And if the sentence is fast, you are, you know, well organized, and you know how, and you know how to, I would say, how to recall. And you know, the more you listen to it, the better you can recall a sentence. So once you are used to listening to long sentences, you will be much better off recalling the sentences. The other way, what you can do is you can always write the initials of each word. Just in case, if a sentence is long, you have a pen and paper there. And you know, like you can always write the initial. For a lot of my students, they say writing the initial of each letter does work for them. So I believe writing the initial, the room of making a mistake reduces, because every word you write, you know that you're not skipping a word. Okay. Sometimes if a sentence is too short, I believe writing a complete sentence quickly on the notepad and then transferring it to the screen would be much better option if you have time. And if you're struggling with the time, then I prefer you to straight away type it, because I want every one of you to finish the exam. Because if you miss out even few words from Write From Dictation, you lose marks, lot of marks. And is there any negative marking, Ayushi?
No, there is no negative marking
for this task. So even if you miss out a task, even if you miss out a word, there is no negative marking, but of course you get a penalty, which is not good.
Yeah. And the second most important thing is your spelling and your punctuation. If you're bad at spellings, then you need to practice common spellings, and you need to practice your punctuation. Wherever there is a compound sentence, then you need to know that you have to put a comma, you have to put the capital letter if there's the proper noun, and you have to put a full stop in the end of the sentence so that the sentence is fully complete, and only then you'll get the full mark of that sentence.
That's very true. Because the marks are, guys, the marks are going towards your writing section. What is writing? Writing is made up of grammar, right? Writing is made up of punctuation. Writing is made up of spelling. So all these three things are very, very important. Make sure you start a sentence with a capital letter. You finish a sentence with a full stop. So the guidelines clearly state, so if you make a punctuation error, you lose marks. There's no negative marking, but of course you lose marks. Okay. And is there anything else, Ayushi, about the Write From Dictation task which students need to know?
No, the only problem students face is they say the sentence was really lengthy, they couldn't get it. Mm-hmm. So initially you have to see that the writing initial method, it won't work for the very, you know, you start doing it today and you will say that it's going to work today only. It never happens. You have to practice for a couple of days, mm-hmm. because our hand is not very perfect in writing the initials. Whatever the computer says, it's very hard to write the first letter of each word in the initial days. But after some practice, maybe a week or so, you'll be perfect in that. You'll be looking for a pen and paper as soon as you see, listen to the dictation, and you feel like writing the whole sentence. And believe me, many of the students have successfully done their exam by using this technique, and nothing else works in the exam. We have practiced a lot, we have experimented a lot. This is the best technique we have come up. So you do at home, what you do is you put some audios in, put the earphones in, and your hand should be very fast, and you should be able to capture each and every initial word, and your typing should be well enough that you quickly type the whole sentence on the computer screen.
Yeah. Another thing is, like these days what's happening is a lot of students, they are struggling with the time. Guys, in listening, you have to allocate your time to each question by yourself. Make sure you allocate it wisely. You have to be very careful that, you know, tasks like multiple choice questions, and you know, anywhere, select missing words, wherever you have multiple options, they are, as compared to the other tasks, they are a low weightage task. The Write From Dictation is a very high weightage task. So you cannot afford to miss this task. So sometimes in order to do those tasks, students, you know, they focus too much on those tasks, they allocate too much of their time on those tasks, and they are not very, you know, by the time they reach on this question, the left time is only say 1 minute, which is definitely not enough for you guys to do all of the Write From Dictations. So I would recommend you guys to please manage your time wisely when you are doing listening section. Make sure come what may, you should not be skipping this task. Another important thing is always click next. So once you are done with the first sentence, make sure you've revised it, you've put a full stop, and click next. Don't wait for the system to automatically take you to the next question, because it won't. You have to click next in listening section. Make sure you do it, you know, when the question finishes. Ayushi, is there anything else about Write From Dictation which our students need to know?
they need to practice. There are so many websites nowadays which says they get similar dictation as they are in the real exam. Mm-hmm. So they should practice those websites. Some of them are D2L on YouTube. There mm-hmm. is a lot of practice you can do on PTE tutorials yeah. as well. So I would say you should practice the whole listening tests, not yeah. one, more than one. So what happens is when you practice, you become habitual of maintaining the time and dividing the time for each task, not doing separate tasks, but do it as a complete test.
So that's right. Every correct word you write, it will fetch you marks. So make sure you write each and every word correctly. Another thing which Ayushi said was the website PTE Tutorials. As most of you guys know, PTE Tutorials gives you, you know, the best platform. There is no other website that will give you complete 30 mock tests to practice. So PTE Tutorials, it has got the best material where, you know, if you enroll with us, any of our, if you take any of, whether it's 3 weeks coaching, a master class or unlimited coaching, you get access to, you know, a lot of mock tests, which will definitely help you a lot to achieve your desired scores. And some of the resources on the web, they also have, you know, where you can type and where you can listen to the sentence, adjusting the, you know, speed of the sentence, the accent of the sentence. So you should always, you know, practice with those. For example, there's a TED Talks and sometimes PTE study where, you know, you can adjust the speed of the sentence. So adjusting, so eventually you can start off with a little bit slow speed and then go up to a little bit high speed, because this gives you a virtual idea of what you can expect in your exam. Isn't it, Ayushi?
It is. Okay. So practice is the key to success here. Mm-hmm. The more you practice is, the more number of words you'll get is correct. And of course, you'll get your listening as well as your writing marks. Especially if you are looking for 8 each, this task has to be 100% correct.
Yeah.
10 on 10. Then only you can expect your marks to be, you know, 8 each. Many students, they say, oh, we miss one dictation because of the time, or we couldn't get the accent, or we couldn't get the some of the words. That means, you know, there's some room for...
Basically, whole PTE exam, I believe, relies on your speaking and your listening. So once you're good with these two areas, you'll automatically fetch marks for the other areas. And another thing is, we are very happy today because yesterday, one of our students who took the master class, Taimur Muhammad, he scored a perfect score, which is more than 80 in all of the tasks. So friends, if you are struggling with PTE, I believe we are there to help you in any of the areas you're struggling, whether, you know, you have 2 weeks in hand, whether you have 1 day in hand, or whether you have ample of time. We are always there to help you. We have different packages. We've got a masterclass coming up on 6th of October. So if you are, you know, short of time, you just have a day, and if you've got your exam anytime sooner or later, you know, I would say anytime in October, and you struggle to manage your time to come to classes every day, it's the best platform. It's a 1 day class. It's a 1 day, 7 hour session in which we discuss each and every detail of PTE. So if you're struggling in any of the tasks, you can enroll for that masterclass. And we have other packages depending on your needs also. So friends, if you're struggling with PTE, we are always there to help you. So think PTE, think Aussies would be the best slogan so far, I think. Mm-hmm. What do you say, Ayushi?
It is. So we are always there to help you. Don't hesitate to come in. So you'll find a homely atmosphere here. We are not only academically, we support the people mentally as well. So we motivate them that it's a very easy task, it tests, and it is the last hurdle to your permanent residency. Sooner or later you have to do it, why not now?
Thank you so much and have a very good evening.